serious.
First show
we want to talk about that we had this year was I Speak Art.
I Speak Art was a brilliant, wonderful show. And and we were also able to sit down with a few of those artists as well to kind of get their take on how they do what they do, and maybe, you know, get a little bit of background, a little bit of feel on them. And, you know, so this is who we had.
Check it out.
Simon Rodia was a form of inspiration, but not the form of inspiration. I was also lucky enough to work with a professional artist who lived two doors down. Me and my younger brother and his son, we would all play, and we would have opportunities to come in and
work. My first really great pieces were in high school, and I had some really nice pencil drawings during my time in high school. I had some great art teachers. I had five different art teachers at the high school that I attended in Detroit, Michigan. And I remember this pencil drawing that I did of some shoes. And it was a still life, but it was really good. And the instructor kept it, actually. It ended up in the exhibit. So that was one of my early pieces.
All that jazz show was a brilliant show as well. It featured many, many jazz enthusiasts. Biggest of them all has to be Sam Pace. Sam's work was exceptional in his field. I mean, you know, but to coin the phrase, Sam is not just a regular painter or artist. He's a
jazz artist, a jazz visual artist. He represented that.
It influences my work. Instead of making music, this is my way of interpreting the music and keeping it alive too. To me, it's really important to keep the jazz music alive because it's ours. We created it. Not to be cliche, but it's America's classical music.
He did definitely represented that. But we also had Charles Dixon that had some beautiful work that represented jazz on the wall. We had Dale Davis. These are icons in the industry, and we were thankful for them allowing us to put a show on featuring them. Mm-hmm. And then
let's not forget Robert Miller.
We would like to thank Congresswoman Maxine Waters for coming out, and we hosted her. She came out with 100 black women to tour. They did a cultural tour, and the Creative House was selected as one of those entities that they came and visit.
I just happened to wander into this gallery, and I could not believe it was here because it is so wonderful, and the art that was displayed was so different.
My name is Kanum Alexander. This is my dear brother, Rasta. And we are the proprietors here at this lovely gallery. I want to call it the Black Gallery in Inglewood. The Congresswoman said, I'm the branding director, so we do marketing and branding. So we're like a marketing and branding firm, and you mix that with art, you get this creative hodgepodge of beauty.
But, and we also would like to thank Lila Hood. Lila Hood came through with her troops, and she brought swag in form of strings and violin play. Lila, just a straight shout out for us to the Creative House. We welcome you.
And also, Lila did, as far as the all that jazz, she did International Jazz Day. We did a tribute to International Jazz Day along with the All That Jazz show. And Lila came in and brought the house down.
She single-handedly coordinated that entire event.
Yes.
So, you know, we want to say thank you to Lila Hood for coordinating that event and actually
do it again.
Creating something that was so memorable that I can't wait to do it again.
Yeah, so I'm ready.
Lila, give a brother call Lila. Call a brother.
Call a brother. Lila. The blue violinist, yes.
Yeah. The city of Englewood for their support and help along with different various issues that we might have had coming up for our opening. You know, their support has been poignant and monumental for us to create a great space here in the city of Englewood. So we wanted to give a shout out. City of Englewood, thank you very much for your help and your
thank
support.
Thank you. Appreciate it. And they've been opening their arms towards this art and culture that we're presenting downtown. In downtown Englewood, we're revitalizing Market Street, and I know the city is really thriving on getting that done. So we're just a piece of the puzzle to help that process. So yeah, again, thank you, City of Englewood. Love event.
The love event was very, very dope. It was our spoken word event for that we were kind of creating for the year, and it will be back in 2018 as well. It features two of one of my favorite people, you know, and I give this young one brother a hard time, but he's dope as hell. Sekou, whose pen name is Papa Sag, he's a novelist, and he came in to host the event along with Becca Love, and they just basically did their thing. And we gotta also thank our artist Mansoir, who was the feature for that first event.
Yeah,
and
dope.
And, you know, they came in, they did their thing. Here's a recap. You can take a look at some of these performances.
Yeah, this is dopeness.
From dopeness.
Check it out.
Giants obstruct the pathway to your heart, leaving me in despair. With a warrior spirit, I prepare to cut them at the ankles. You are worth every fight. Every entanglement that hinders the objective, every roadblock is ineffective. You are the prize. The beauty of a thousand lifetimes that comes once in a million decades, conquering the heavens so you can sit on your throne, your majesty, the Virgo. Your face is etched in my soul. I will fight monsters to win your heart. Greet them in hell and tear every limb apart and proclaim you as queen. Nothing more majestic has been seen. Nothing more prestige. You are the center of what's happening with God's perfected, poignant blend of comedic and African, that mole above your lip, that smile that brightens up Pluto from Earth. Only after God and His Christ, you are the center of my universe. So giants fall at my wake, and there's nothing they can do to stop me. In my own imagination, I've pictured you, Adrian, and I'm your only Rocky. Your only prize fighter, because you're the only prize to bask in your beauty and melt into your eyes, your majesty, the Virgo. Swim the seven seas and climb the highest mountain, conquer the deepest deserts, overcoming the worst of tempers. Grateful that you were brought into this world on any day of September. Your beautiful features hide your more beautiful heart, your more beautiful soul, your more beautiful spirit. So every time I see your face, deep down in your essence, I can feel it. Your majesty, the Virgo.
Love, how much do you want? There's abundance in love. How much do you? Love brings light.
DJ Solo.
Solo! Solo, what it do?
Solo came in, and you know, he does this thing all the time, every month, so he creates this event here called Equinox. And Equinox is kind of like a jazz, fusion, funk, reggae, dance hall. It's a fusion of every single music form that there is. So, you know, we come in and
mixed with body painting.
Ooh, that body painting.
Wow.
I'm still mad about that body painting, but Solo knows what's up.
yeah. Mixed with body painting. So you get not just your regular kind of go out kind of theme, you get an experience. And that's what Solo was bringing to the table with Equinox.
Yes.
And we're kicking Equinox off back in 2018. But check out a little footage from Equinox. Here we go.
At 2:21 p.m., the sun crossed the celestial equator, putting our day and night in complete balance with each other. So by definition, that's what's known as equinox. But that's not what I think of when I think of equinox. When I think of equinox, I think of September 23rd, 1926, when softly as a morning sunrise, the birth of a jazz grind stepped in pursuit of a love supreme. Breaking all meter and time, when he played the saxophone, so it seemed. Make a transition from summertime to opening up my soul eye with the auto serenade. Traveling from Mars, Venus, Saturn, Jupiter variation through interstellar space. Spiraling into serenity, willing to give all or nothing at all. When I hear a rhapsody of his melody, it's almost like the brother was telling me, you don't know what love is. Well, shoot, I'm still trying to figure out who Naima was, so if you know her, can you hook a brother up? One of the homies told me she's staying on the east side of Long Beach, rocking the Afro blue. I peeped a little Instagram and I instantly fell into a sentimental mood. That is the Equinox piece, y'all. And I'm looking more once again to Equinox. We have a dope little lineup tonight.
Now, for you folks that missed one of the most magnanimous events of 2017,
it was grown and sexy.
To be our wine unveiling of Melanin, created by Paul Charles. Paul Charles came in and kind of, you know, gave us a little bit of different ambiance and basically groaned up the gallery, you know.
Yeah,
with this event.
Just imagine this, and you'll check out the pictures definitely that we're going to have on here, but we bought these wine barrels in here. Now this aroma, the sensual aroma was in the air with this wine.
Ooh.
And then it was so elegant. It was just so...
If you missed that event...
Miss the next one.
No. Definitely come out to the next one.
And Paul.
Paul Charles.
Bring it back, bro.
Yeah.
Let's run it back.
We plan on doing other wine tastings in 2018. So you don't want to miss any of these that's coming up, because I'm going to tell you, they're going to knock your socks off. They're going to knock your socks off.
So that Pinot Noir, Paul Charles, 2014 and 15. You're talking about tantalizing your taste buds. Yeah, we're going to run that back.
Yeah, definitely.
Thanks, Paul Charles, for coming it up and bringing it up.
Here's a recap of that event. And, pay note to who's in these places and who. So, because you want to be here.
You definitely want to be here.
Take a look.
We had this event We had about four Rebel Talks.
We have had about four now, for the show, because we kind of started Rebel Talk in the middle of the year. Mm-hmm. And Rebel Talk was simply our fix on saluting and paying homage to non-visual artists who are doing something great, not only in the community, but in their craft and their fields.
Yeah.
So, and with that, we had to bring in Karamu Kush, who's award-winning director.
Director, writer. Actor, writer.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, we had to bring him in. We also had to bring in
Chef Babette.
Chef Babette.
Ooh, from
Chef
Stuff Babette. I Eat. You talking about creating a rebel experience. Now, Chef Babette, if you know her, she's created like vegan vegetarianism in a place that it wasn't even here.
No.
When she created it.
And you wanna definitely pay close attention to each individual that's in the Rebel Talk series now, because they're doing some magnanimously great things.
Yeah, we had Razzcass, probably the West Coast lyrical legend. I mean, this cat, we interviewed him. So, and we also interviewed one of my friends, one of my mentors, or one of my Jegnas, however you want to call it. And that was Purusha Hickson. He's been studying yoga for over 40 years. His Swamini was Alice Coltrane. So just to have a sit down with these type of individuals at Rebel Talk was just beautiful. And we're gonna have more of them. So come on, Rebels, let's talk.
And you can expect to see a lot more geniusness from other different individuals within the Rebel Talk series.
And I would just want to thank also, because one of the producers on that
can't leave show
is Vidal Marsh.
Vidal Marsh
has been a friend to the Creative House. He's always like pumping up the Creative House, and this is something that he brought to the table, really, and we just said, okay, let's collaborate and get it done. Creative House is a nonprofit entity. So to keep art and culture alive, you can donate to the Creative House right here.
You can also go to our website as well, thecreativehouse.org. It's being restructured, but you can go there now to thecreativehouse.org and hit the donate button. You hit that donate button and then, you know, give whatever you can.
That little address below. Yeah, let's hit that up.
There's an address below?
Yeah. It will be there.
This is like camera magic.
It's an address below.
Oh, shit. Yeah. Excuse me. I don't know if I'm saying that on camera, but hey, right there.
There we go. So we sort of summed up 2017 for us. Look forward to great things in 2018.
We're going to kick off 2018 with our Creative House Creative Courses.
Yes.
Which will inundate individuals with learning. You know, we're trying to shorten that gap between us and some of the schools and some of our other folks that just need to know some of this various information. Mm-hmm. So what you'll be able to understand in its entirety or come in and learn will be all of our digital aspects, from the photography to how to edit different footage, different films, different photos as well. You'll also be able to learn some different techniques in terms of in the sculptural areas, you know, like with clay and wood, and how to carve and how to sculpt. Some painting also will be inundated in that. So you'll be able to get a full round of how to be an artist.
Yeah,
what art is.
And that's so important, because that was one of the reasons we came here to Inglewood, is to fill the void that, you know, there's no longer art in schools, no longer for students to be able to be creative. So we're here to fill that void and touch some of the students in the schools around us.
Mm-hmm. And with that being said, let's get to this show.
The show we got going on right
this
now.
This show.
This show is called Identity Theft by
Michael Chooks.
I want to just say, the Master Chooks.
Well,
I don't know if he likes to be called Master Artist. The Artist Chooks.
You can say the artist too.
The artist.
Master too. Cut is like a little bit of an understatement for this cat.
Yeah.
Now, with that being said, let's go into Identity Theft and some of my favorite pieces.
Some of our favorite pieces. Can we do our favorite pieces?
No, I'm just doing mine.
Are we just doing yours?
I'm just doing mine right now. Yeah,
okay.
You can do yours next. Okay. I guess I'll share it.
We can do
some of our favorite pieces.
Yes. Check it out.
I think my last name, I looked up to see what we do and what we did in history. And those Benin artists, those Benin sculptures are Nigerian. That's part of my culture. So I'm celebrating that. But even going further, if you understand the genealogy of who you are and understand history, we all, black, white, yellow, brown, red, we all come from, we originated in Africa.
Yes.
And we migrated throughout the world.
Yes.
So when you look at those pieces, yes, I'm from Nigeria and it's part of my culture, but we're all from Africa. Yes. So when you look at that, you're seeing yourself as a king and a queen. Doesn't matter what color you are.
Thank you.
You know, so I'm just putting it in perspective. And that's what that's why I call it the Royal Corridor, because I want you to experience yourself as that.
Thank you.
About the Creative House, staying on that cutting edge and creating new things, new events, as your mecca for art and culture and just some straight up classy stuff.
And there's also a lot of other people who have been behind the scenes, too many to really name.
Yeah, we just want to thank you.
So we want to thank you as well. At the end of this, you know, just take a little peek at some of the names who helped incorporate us and made us the Creative House. And we want to say, give a shout out and special love and warm welcome.
Much
and
gratitude.
For those people coming back and those and inundating themselves within our cipher once again. Yeah. So we want to thank you people as well.
And remember, this is not just our Creative House.
Well, this is not our.
This is not just our Creative House.
I thought it was all mine.
No. This
Wait,
is
it's not mine. Your, the hell?
This is your Creative House.
Oh, okay. Well, I guess. We'll share it.
Yeah. Mi casa, su casa. And we're out.